Greetings all, greetings, greetings, greetings. One of my locations where I love to sit and observe life around me. It's a great day here, sunny. The clouds hanging in the sky, just light clouds, nice wind. It is a cool morning. The reason for me making this video today is somebody sent me, one of my friends sent me a video, a TikTok video with this lady showing up Germany and Israel and the rest of the people who created the nation of Israel and put it where it's located today. For the sole purpose of trying to disrupt the other Middle Eastern nations to control the mineral wealth, which mostly right now is oil. But as you know, another nation was pulling all the water it needs out of the desert, which people think is just sand. People think there's just sand there, but the mineral wealth of the Sahara is, if you think Africa, lower Africa, the southern part of Africa has wealth. You don't know about the northern part yet. And the central, what we'll call just below Morocco and Libya and Egypt. There's so much wealth there. Anyway, let me give you a listen to what this woman has to say. By the way, she's a black lady, African-American lady, African lady. And I'll come back and kind of add a little bit to what she has to say.
Hey guys, so a recent incident has really illustrated why it's important to know history, because not knowing history can sometimes bite you in the butt. So the country of Germany decided to clap back at South Africa for its genocide filing against Israel. They said, well, they're going to put forward a brief supporting Israel and essentially rebuking South Africa for claiming that Israel is committing genocide in Gaza. Well, along comes the country of Namibia. Namibia, here you can see it. Here's the map. It's at the very southern tip of Africa, right next to South Africa. Namibia steps forward and says, hold up, Germany. Is this you? Oop. Turns out Germany perpetrated not just the best known 20th century genocide, obviously the one in the 1930s and 40s against 6 million Jewish people in Europe. They also committed the very first genocide that took place in the 20th century against Namibia. Here's how that went. So Germany occupied Namibia, like a lot of Europeans were occupying parts of Africa. They did so starting in the 1880s. They put about 5,000 settlers in Namibia and proceeded to enslave the population of Namibia, which consisted of multiple different tribes. When two of those tribes rose up to try to expel their occupiers in 1904, a German general decided that his tactic in pushing back against their freedom fight was going to be genocide, killing 20 to 30,000 of them and then putting thousands more in concentration camps. These were the first concentration camps that we saw in the 20th century, long before Germany then used concentration camps against Jews in Europe. So the irony of it is rich indeed that Namibia pushed back against Germany, which is now a four-square supporter of Israel, you know, probably a lot of, you know, historical guilt making them say, no, we're going to always jump out in front and be extremely supportive of Israel, as does the United States and Britain. But in the case of Germany, Namibia said, y'all might not have the moral authority to do this. You might want to pull up. And that was not just the president of Namibia, but also the first lady, who issued her own rebuke of Germany, saying they don't know their history enough, or at least have not acknowledged it enough, for them to be speaking on this issue. Your periodic reminder that the global South is so sick of Europe. They are over Europe, and they are not playing with them. And that means that they're not really playing with Israel, who is, of course, allied with the West. Sorry, y'all, the global South is over the West, and the West better figure out what to do about it, because this is not going to end with Gaza.
Sister just nailed it. Not just her, but the Namibians. I mean, they are right on top of things. The leadership in Namibia is on top of things. But let me tell you, give you some background about this. When South Africa took Israel to the court, the ICJ, Israel sent out a memo to every country saying, you will come to our aid. You will support us. Otherwise, we are going to destroy you. You hear what I'm telling you? Israel came out boldly. They didn't even hide it. That's why you see every American congressman have full support behind Israel. They have to. Israel's got the goods on every one of them. Those who do not support Israel, and Israel don't have the goods on them, they're trying to get them out of office and replace it with somebody who they want. Every black congressman who has ever said anything against Israel or withhold their speech in support of Israel, Israel goes after them. The other thing is, when this war in Ukraine started, I said to you, don't get involved. Go back and look at my videos and do not get involved. Stay out of this. There's a reason why I said it. Because we as Africans have an outsized effect on world events, even though we don't see it. We have an outsized effect on world events, on the world, even though we don't see it. And it began with the European. Their obsession with keeping us down, making us appear as the least, some of them call us, well, this is this Jewish guy from Israel in the government. The other day, I made a video about it. Go back and look at the video about 3 days ago. Call us subhuman. And that's what the U.S. government did in the beginning. We weren't human. We are two-thirds. It was agreement that they come to between them to get the approval of the states to sign the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution, that black people couldn't get the same rights. So in order for black skin, the African not get the same rights, they had to be less than human. But it's not Germany only that committed genocide against Africa. Belgium, the British. There's a little island off Australia called Tasmania. The British and Australians, not the Aborigines, but the Caucasian Australians, killed every one of the people on that island. And the world was silent. The British in Kenya, Tanzania, Uganda, the French, they're still committing genocide today in Africa. Well, the British too. You can ask the Kenyans about that. The British Army is still there. And they're still doing what they feel like it. The Kenyan government is silent. The Germans, it's only Namibia, but I'm concerned with Africa, so the rest of the people who don't speak up for themselves, they have to do it. One of them is the Native American, the Hessians. I don't know if you guys know about the Hessians. They murdered in the name of the U.S. government. So many of the Native Americans. Every European country, Spanish, the Portuguese, every one of them, the Dutch, has committed genocide around the world and in Africa. So when Israel sent out their order that you will support us at the ICJ, you will support us or we'll destroy your country, your economy, your people. They didn't know that what they were getting into. They knew it actually, but they thought they were so big that nobody could stand up against them. So now Germany kind of just stuck their tail between their legs and stood up and got slapped by Namibia first. Now, all the others now, when they still stand up, I want to see who is going to slap them down in Africa. You probably won't see Ghanaian government, Nigerian government, the Kenyan government stand up and say, hey, nope, you can't talk about that when you got this record. Sit down, you're not supporting Israel. I want to see all of them stand up and say that. They better stand up. Like I said, the 3-year period is coming, and you see they're going after South Africa. I told you, 3 years till these people turn around and come back for Africa. And we better be prepared. Anyway, I hope those of the African governments who have been sitting on the side and wavering are preparing now, looking at the world as it is, and seeing that you have an outsized effect on the whole planet. Everybody is keeping an eye on Africa and what Africans do. The fear of Africa permeates everything on planet Earth. Stay safe. Enjoy your day wherever you are. Watch events as they unfold so that you are prepared. Don't let it scare you. Information can help you to plan, or when it comes time to react, you know exactly what to do. Peace.